Hi, and welcome to the next chapter of the Christian Fiction Bookshelf Podcast. I'm your host, Jamie Vaughn. This chapter of the Christian Fiction Bookshelf Podcast is sponsored by Revell, a division of Baker Publishing Group. We have Melissa Koslin here with her latest book called Never Miss. Hi, Melissa. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I am doing very well. I would love to hear about your latest book, Never Miss.
So it's a Christian romantic suspense. Mm-hmm. It's very fast paced. Basically it's about a pending bio attack. And no, I wrote this before 2020. Not my fault.
It's kind of pertinent now.
Yeah, exactly. So when it hit last year, I'm like, oh my goodness, everybody's going to think that I wrote it for this, but no, it was in the publisher's hands already before it even hit. So, and no, I'm not prophetic.
Well, I can mark that question off because that was, you know, I was going to ask about that. So you beat me.
Yeah, no, not so much. But it's about Cadence Toll and Lyndon Vale. And I'm looking at my book cover here. He almost gets killed. She ends up saving his life. And this very unlikely duo helps stop a bio attack that would probably kill most of the earth.
Oh, wow. Now tell me more about Cadence and Lyndon.
Cadence is interesting character. She has kind of a dark past. She has a difficult family life situation. She was actually raised by snipers, which raised by a family of snipers, and she was fine with that. She really enjoys shooting. She really enjoys the accuracy of it and everything, but her family uses it in bad ways, which she didn't know as she was growing up. Mm-hmm. Then she became a CIA agent and got into all kinds of deep, dark things there, poor thing. And then Lyndon, he is a scientist, 3 doctorates, very extraordinarily, just one of those really extraordinary people. And he has discovered that Ebola is, well, I won't give you too much, but he's discovered something interesting about Ebola, and somebody's trying to kill him about it.
Now, how in the world do you do research on a book like this? It seems a lot involves CIA and bio attacks and crazy viruses. I would love to hear your research.
Well, as far as the sniper stuff goes, I actually have a friend who was a Marine sniper. Mm-hmm. So researched everything just online as much as I could. And then I sent him all those sections of the book to say, okay, does this make sense? Is this, you know, she's the best sniper in history, but at the same time, it needs to be, you know, within reason possible. Right. So he actually had me change the type of gun that she uses, which was super helpful, but otherwise he said it would look pretty good. So there's that. And then of course, as far as traveling goes, it's Google Earth. You know, and then everything else is just dig.
Mm-hmm. Now, what do you want the reader to take away when they sit down and read this book cover to cover?
I want them to escape into something fun, first and foremost. Second, I really like that the two characters are so completely and totally different. They're polar opposites in a lot of ways, but at the same time, they appreciate their differences. They realize, okay, she's stronger at this. I'm going to let her take the lead. And she does the same thing. And they balance each other really well. And so instead of taking their differences and clashing, mm-hmm. which they had some struggles here and there, but for the most part, they don't clash too bad. They just figure out how to trust each other and balance each other. And instead of having fighting, you know, I feel like that would be nice if everybody in the world could do that, you know, appreciate each other's differences and just, you know, instead of clashing.
Yeah. Now, how do you work the faith element into a book like this?
This one is actually the way Lyndon came to faith. Now, I was born and raised Christian, so I already had faith. But, you know, as I was getting old enough to really think about it for myself, like during the preteen years and stuff, mm-hmm. I started really thinking about it because I'm a very logical person, a lot like Lyndon. So I had to logically get myself through it to really feel, you know, that deep faith. So that's where Lyndon comes from. And his concepts, the way he thinks also comes from some of the books that I've read, but it's mostly from how I came to faith through logic. Mm-hmm. So that I really wanted that in a book. And so I thought that was fun that he's the logical scientist and he's the one who teaches her how to have faith.
Oh, I love
which
that.
Is kind of the backwards from what you would assume.
Right, right. I love twists like that. Well, Melissa, thank you so much for coming by. And thank you everyone for joining us today for the Christian Fiction Bookshelf Podcast. I'm your host, Jamie Vaughn. And thank you, Melissa, for joining us today to talk about your latest book, Never Miss. And there are more details below in the chapter notes. If you like this chapter of the Christian Fiction Bookshelf Podcast, click the subscribe button below so you don't miss another chapter.